What do you think is the most important thing for a young woman to know?
I would say know yourself.
I think you should really stick together as a family, do things together at some times.
Well, the important thing to know your own value.
Just having compassion for someone and letting them know that.
Don't ever put aside any goal that you have for yourself because of a relationship with a guy.
Take care of yourself.
Wow. I think in terms of my granddaughters, when I was raising my daughter, and I'm alluding to the fact that I was in a different place when I was raising my daughter. I was going to school. I was working on my master's degree, raising my daughter. And then I was working every day. I was moving up in positions within the school district, which meant more responsibility, more time away from home. And so I couldn't devote the kind of time to my daughter. I was a good mother, but that I think just being able to be at home with her and do things with her, I just didn't have the time to do it.
Sometimes we get so busy and we get so drawn in and we kind of forget about compassion. I find myself having to work on myself even as I go along because I really believe that compassion is a trait that if more people had it and practiced it, we would be in much better, you know, shape than we are now.
I raise my children to look out for each other. And arguments and stuff like that, I know they had, but that's as far as it went. Because I didn't let it get any further than that, you know. No, you're not going to get any further than that. That's it. So you're back to where you started.
So I look at with being with my granddaughters as a second opportunity to be the kind of person to them that I couldn't always be to their mother. And so I give them advice. I give a lot of advice. Sometimes they don't know it's advice, but it's advice.
Never really depend on anyone else to take care of you. And this is why I value education. You need to go to school. You need to prepare yourself for a job.
Always put yourself first. Put yourself first. Don't ever do anything or go anyplace just because a guy is asking you to. Only go if you want and only do what he's asking if you want to do that.
I think even though, you know, people put you down, because a lot of people are going to put you down, but you have to ignore them and be yourself.
And you have to learn how to just sit back, as my mother used to say, be still, and observe. You know, keep your little mouth closed sometimes, and that way your ears will probably open a little wider, and you can hear what's going on. And then you can become a judge of people. You can judge people quite easily if you do that. But most people are just so interested in talking that they don't take the time to really listen and observe.
Well, taking care of your body, taking care of yourself, and just be careful who you associate your life with.
Everybody says eating the right food, exercise. Those are important. Both of those are important. But also being happy. And you need to be happy. If you're happy, that means you're doing what you want to do. You're living the lifestyle that you want to live.
See, you have to not lean on your own understanding. You have to trust God and just know that He's with you and He got things already planned for you. Do you know that everything that we've gone through, God already know about it? He already planned, He already got your life planned for you.
I do go to church and I do pray and I like to read inspirational things and things like that. And I feel that, you know, if you know there's a God, then that helps.
Most women my age might pick something like religion. I can't really say that. And that, it's simply because I'm spiritual. I grew up as a Catholic, but I'm not a church-going person. And I probably haven't been. I mean, I go on the occasions, you know. But as a child, I used to go to church. I went to Catholic school, so I used to go to church every day. So maybe I wore out.
I don't think, you know, just because you don't have enough money to feed your family, you go out and steal. I think you deal with what's in that cabinet and make up something, you know. And if you have to work to get it, work. But not on a shady side, because I'm a firm believer of what goes around comes around. And I do this for me, not for no one else. So you got to be true to yourself.
So it's not the spiritual thing that has, you know, maintained me. I just think it's an outlook. It's what is the word I'm looking for? It's an outlook how I am able to just take everything in and not let it become overwhelming, in other words, and it's probably a better word for it, but, you know, I have gone through some things in my life, no doubt, all of us have, but some things that, you know, that a lot of people I know I don't think would have successfully been able to maneuver and get through. So because I don't take it that seriously, and I don't say, oh my God, I'll never get over this, because I got over not having a mother, you know? You do. You learn how to survive.
I think going to church is great, is important. And you don't have to live in the church.
And for that, I guess I do really have to thank God, because you know, it was His doing to make me be able to do that.
Okay. Carter, okay. How do you know if someone is truly a friend?
Well, if they're truly your friend, you're not putting on airs and they're not putting on airs. They're not phony people. Your true friend is almost like yourself. They understand you and you understand them. And the two of you are better for it.
My advice, and I give you this as an older person who probably views life a little differently. When I was younger, yes, I sought medical advice when there was something wrong. You know, if I had a toothache, then I go to the dentist. If I have some other issue, I'll go to the doctor. But as I got older, I think about my family and that it's really important for me to take as good a care of myself as I can, because I owe that to you guys and to Grandpa. I owe that. If I just let my health go, then I'm not really serving you well by doing that.
You never joined a sorority. Was there like a reason? You know, I know a lot of your friends are in sororities and you do have a lot of social clubs, but why didn't you ever decide to join like a sorority group or anything like that?
Well, when I got to the age that I could be in a sorority, I had friends that was in it. And after listening to them and things that they had to do, I knew I wasn't going to do that. So I was the type of a person that if they said, you come over here and clean up my house, no, I'm not doing that. So, I mean, I couldn't have made it. I really could not have, because I was a person, my own person. And I felt that I wasn't going to do all of these things just because you told me to do them. No. And to be into something like that, no.
But you are interested in staying healthy, right?
Definitely.
But not to the extreme. I mean, you know your body, right?
Yes.
And you know when something is different than what it normally is, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you go for your checkups. You've been doing that ever since you were little babies. At first we were taking you, or your mom was taking you, and now you guys know how to do that by yourselves. And I think that is just marvelous.
Adulting.
That's a good term. I like that. We're adulting now.
Yeah, I'm trying.
I feel like this is something I need off my chest. Cause when I look into your eyes, I can't find nothing there.
Are there any lessons that you wish to unlearn from your grandmother?
No. What if she sees this? Observing over time women that you love and respect and that made you swallowing their voice or silencing their voice or allowing themselves to be diminished by the other people in the room. Like when you see people shrink, I think it has an effect.
And it's like, although like I hate when she does it to me, like I find myself doing it. And I was like, dang, it done sweeped in, you know, that sort of thing.
You really have to focus on your life sometimes, because we can get caught up in, like, other people's business, other people's social media posts. You'll find yourself scrolling all day long, and you haven't accomplished anything for yourself.
What did you learn from me? What's one thing that you picked up from me that would help you in your life?
I actually picked up a lot from you, Grandma.